Hi friends, welcome back to Angular unit testing series. In this series, I'm talking about unit testing in Angular using Jasmine framework. In the last video, I have explained about how we can test an Angular component. In this video, let's see about how we can test an Angular component which is having some DOM interactions. To explain that, I have changed our app component and implemented this functionality. Here I have a button. On clicking this button, I'm calling a function. Initially, I have kept a Boolean variable as false. And inside this function, I'm changing that to true. Also, I'm having a string with value as subscribe. And I'm changing that to subscribed inside this function. Also, based on this flag value, I'm disabling this button. And so we can see this. When I click this button, the button is disabled. And the button text is changed to subscribed. By the by, have you subscribed to my channel? Please do it. It takes only few seconds to subscribe, but it means a lot to me. Thanks. Okay, let's start to test this functionality now. In the app component spec file, we can see already the testing module is configured. But it is configured only to test whether the component instance is created correctly. To test our functionality, we need to access the DOM elements. For that, we need to create a debug element using fixture. So first, let's create a fixture. I can actually create the fixture inside the then block of compile components. Okay, now we can create a debug element using the fixture. Also, we need to create a component instance to initialize some of the values. So let's create a component variable and create an instance. Okay, our setup is ready. Let's write our spec. Let me copy this and modify. It should render a button with text subscribe. First, let us access this button element using the query all utility from the debug element. I can actually use this class name. Okay, now I can set these values in the component instance. We have already seen, after we set these values, we have to trigger the change detection. Otherwise, it won't reflect. And so, let me call fixture.detectChanges. Now we can write the code to test the functionalities what we expect. For that, I can use the expect utility, in which first I can check whether the text content of this button is going to be subscribed. And then I can also test whether the disabled property is going to be false. That means the button is not disabled. And so we can see our test is getting passed. Let's also test the status of the button after it is clicked. For that, let me create another spec. Let me copy this and modify. It should render a button with text subscribed and the button should be disabled after clicked. Actually, here I can simply pass the value as true and button text as subscribed, and then I can expect the text content to be subscribed and the disabled property to be true. We can see our test is getting passed. But this is not the right way, because here we are not actually testing the DOM interaction. We are just hard coding and testing the logic. That is not right. So let's see how we can do the DOM interaction and test the logic. Let me revert the values to the original values. And so our test will not pass this time. Now I can trigger the click event using native element.click. Like this. Please note that we need to do this before we trigger the change detection. Now we can see our test is getting passed. This is how we can test the functionalities having DOM interactions. Hope you understood. Okay, now I am going to rewrite this code. Instead of one button, let me use two buttons. And show one of them using ngif based on the Boolean flag. I have hardcoded the disabled property in the second button, and also I am not using the button text variable. Instead, I have hardcoded that too. And having the click event only in the first button. Now the functionality is same. But if you see, our test case is going to fail. Cannot read properties of undefined reading native element. That is because we are loading one of these two buttons dynamically using ngif. So at this point, as we are not passing the value to isSubscribe boolean, the debug element could not find the button element because it is inside ngif. So I need to move this initialization before this code. And I don't want to pass the button text value because I am not using that. And I need to move this fixture.detect changes before this. Only then it will detect the changes. Now we can see this test case is passed, but the last one is still failing for the same reason. Let's correct that also. Here, let me copy this fixture.detect changes instead of moving, because we need to trigger change detection one more time after we click this button. Let's see. Now it is failing for different reason. It is expecting subscribed, but subscribe is coming. And also it is expecting the disabled property to true, but it is coming as false. Any idea why it is behaving like this? Let me explain. Let me put a console log and print this button element. And we can see it is printing only one element because of this ngif condition. So that is going to be this first button element. But after we click this, the boolean value to ngif is changed. And so this button is removed from the DOM and the second button is now in the DOM. But this button element is still pointing to the old button. That is the reason this is failing. So let me change this const to let, and let me get the new reference again using the CoryAll utility. Now we can see our test is getting passed. So we need to be little careful when we use ngif or whenever the DOM is getting changed dynamically. Okay, before we close, let's see one more scenario. Right now when I click this button, the button text is immediately getting changed and the button is disabled immediately. But actually, we may need to change the button text and status based on some data from backend. Assume we are calling an API. Based on the API response, we may need to change the button text and disable the button. When we hit the API, we may not get the response immediately. Usually, it takes few seconds. Let me move this code inside a set timeout to simulate that scenario. Now, if I click this button, only after 3 seconds, the button is getting disabled. So, we have achieved our requirement. Let's see our test case. It is failing because after we click the button, we are triggering the change detection and then we are expecting immediately to reflect our change. But as we have introduced a set timeout, this becomes asynchronous now. And so, this is failing. Let's introduce the same set timeout here. Now we can see our test is passing, but this is wrong. Let me show you. Right now we are expecting this to be true and we are seeing our test is passing. Let me expect this to be false. Now also we are seeing the test is passing. How can this be possible? That is what I'm going to explain in my next video. Please like this video and support me. I'll be back with next concept soon. Thank you. Bye.